everyone. So I'm Sebastian, and today I will talk about GoPy, a tool to extend C Python with Go. So, well, in a nutshell, GoPy takes a Go package and creates out of it a Python C extension module. Why, would you say? Maybe. Because we have all of those misguided friends who are still using Python and you still want to use Go for your playground or your fun. So there is GoPy. So it takes a Go package, inspects it with the Go types, extracts all of the exported types, funcs, vars, const, and creates a Go package which CGo exports all of those Go identifiers, then creates another C extension module using the C Python API, calling all of those CGo exported identifiers from the first step, and then compiles everything down to a single shared object. So at that point, the tagline is done, so I could just pack my things and sleep perhaps. But let's go through a little Hello World example. So let's say you have this nice package Hello that you want to share with your friends. This Hello package has a Hello func, which takes a string and massages it a little bit, and then, throw it a new one to your user. And to create a C Python C extension module out of it, you just go somewhere under your Python path, and run GoPy, bind the name of the package, and a couple of seconds later, you would get a C module out of it, so the hello.so, that you can just import from your favorite Python 2 prompt, inspect it like any other Python module, so you see that you have your hello string in the package, and in the module, sorry, and then you can call it like any other Python function. Also with the doc strings from the Go package, which has been attached to the Python counterpart. So it created doc strings, it also created a function translating the Go native tag into their Python counterpart. And if you want to look a little bit under the cover or behind the curtain, so we are in a theater, you would see that GoPy created three files, and the first one, hello.go, is actually a main package which has a CGo func hello function, which takes strings and wraps the original hello function and returns back a new string. This CGo func hello has been decorated with the export directive so that it can be called from the C side, which is actually the hello.c file, and in there you have this CPy func hello, which has the usual CPython signature, which takes py objects. The CPy func hello takes those py objects, translates them or converts them into CGo or Go values, call the CGo func hello on that, return a new CGo value, translate it back into a py object, and then here you go, you have your Python function. Right now, GoPy has many features. Some. It wraps name types, structs, methods into Python classes. It's also clever enough to translate the comma error Go idiom into the Python equivalent. Sizes, arrays, and sequence protocol are implemented. There are also many missing features, maps, interfaces, function taking pointers are not implemented, channels neither. So, well, there's still a bunch of work to do, which leads me to my conclusions. Thanks to the nice and simple rules of the formalism of Go, you can, in a reasonably amount of code, automate the inspection of an exported API and translate it into, or wrap it into a Python language. And GoPy is released under the BSD3 license, so come on and join the fun of the complete world domination with CPython. And it's GoPython, GoPy.